ओम अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय पुतले श्रीमते जयपदाका स्वामिनिति नामिने नामाचार्य पादाय निताय कृपा प्रदायिने गौरकथा धामधाय नगर ग्रामतारिने नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशकारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधरा श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे Reading from Srimad-Bhagavatam, Third Canto, 10th Chapter, 28th through 29th Verse. Deva-sargas casta-vidho vibudhah pitaro surah gandharvapsarasah siddha yaksa-raksamsi caranah bhuta-preta-pisacas vidyadhrah kinnaradayah dasaite vidurakhyatah Sargaste visva-srk-krtah. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. The creation of the demigods is of 8 varieties. The demigods, the forefathers, the asuras or demons, the gandharvas and apsaras or angels, the yaksas and raksasas, the siddhas, caranas and vidyadharas, the bhutas, pretas and pisacas, and the superhuman beings, celestial singers, etc., all are created by Brahma, the creator of the universe. As explained in the second canto of Srimad-Bhagavatam, the Siddhas are inhabitants of Siddhaloka, where the residents travel in space without vehicles. And their mere will, they can pass from one planet to another without difficulty. Therefore, in the upper planets, the inhabitants are far superior to the inhabitants of this planet in all matters of art, culture and science. Since they possess brains superior to those of human beings, the spirits and jinn mentioned in this connection are also counted among the demigods, because they are able to perform uncommon functions not possible for men. Srimad Bhagavatam, second canto, 6th chapter, 43rd verse to 45th verse. Aham baho yagna ime prajesha dakshadayo ye bhavat adayascha swarlokapala kagolokapala Drilokapala Stalalokapalaha Gandharva Vidyadhara Charanesha E Yaksharakshoraga Naganataha Eva Rishinam Rishabaha Pitranam Daityendra Siddheshwara Dhana Vendraha Anyechaye Preta Pishacha Bhuta Kushmanda Yadomruga Pakshi Adishaha Yatkincha Loke Bhagavan Mahaswat Ojaha Sahaswat Balavat Kshamavat Shri Vibhuti Atmavat Adbhutaran Tarnam Tatvam Param Ubrupavat Ashwarupam. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. I myself, Brahma, Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu, great generators of living beings like Daksha and Prajapati, yourselves, Narada and Kumaras, heavenly demigods like Indra and Chandra, the leaders of the Bhurloka planets, the leaders of the earthly planets, the leaders of the lower planets, the leaders of the Gandharva planets, the leaders of the Vidyadhara planets, the leaders of the Charanaloka planets, the leaders of the Yakshas, Rakshasas and Uragas, the great sages, the great demons, the great atheists and the great spacemen, as well as the dead bodies, evil spirits, satans, jinn, kushmandas, great aquatics, great beasts and great birds, etc. In other words, anything and everything which is exceptionally possessed of power, opulence, mental and perceptual dexterity, strength, forgiveness, beauty, modesty, opulence and greeting, whether in form or formless, may appear to be the specific truth and form of the Lord, but actually they are not so. They are only a fragment of the transcendental potency of the Lord. Purport. Those in the list given above, beginning from the name Brahmaji, the first living creature within the universe, down to Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu, Narada and other powerful demigods, men, supermen, sages, rishis and other lower creatures of extraordinary strength and opulence, including the dead bodies, satans, evil spirits, jinn, aquatics, birds and beasts, may appear to be the Supreme Lord, but factually none of them is the Supreme Lord. Every one of them possesses only a fragment of the great potencies of the Supreme Lord. The less intelligent man is surprised to see the wonderful actions of material phenomenon as the aborigines are fearful of a great thunderbolt, a great and gigantic banyan tree, or a great lofty mountain in the jungle. For such undeveloped human beings, merely the slight display of the Lord's potency is captivating. A still more advanced person is captivated by the powers of the demigods and goddesses. Therefore, those who are simply astonished by the powers of anything in the creation of the Lord without any factual information of the Lord himself are known as Shaktas, or worshippers of the great powers. The modern scientist is also captivated by the wonderful actions and reactions of natural phenomena, and therefore is also a Shakta. These lower great persons gradually rise to become Shauryas, worshippers of the sun god, or Ganapatyas, worshippers of the mass of people as Janata Janardana or Dharidra Narayana, etc., in the form of worship, in the form of Ganapati, and then rise to the platform of worshipping Lord Shiva in search for the ever-existing soul, and then to the stage of worshipping Lord Vishnu, the super soul, etc., without any information of Govinda, Lord Krishna, who is the original Lord Vishnu. In other ways, some are worshippers of race, nationality, birds, beasts, evil spirits, satans, etc. The general worship of Shani Deva, the lord of distressful condition, and Siddhala Deva, the goddess of smallpox, is also common to the mass of people, and there are many foolish men who worship the mass of people or the poor class of men. So different persons, societies and communities, etc., worship some of the potent manifestations of the Lord, wrongly accepting the powerful object as God. But in this verse it is advised by Brahmaji that none of them is the Supreme Lord. They are only borrowed plumes from the original Almighty Lord, Sri Krishna. When the Lord advises in Bhagavad Gita to worship Him alone, it is to be understood that worshipping Lord Krishna includes worshipping all that is mentioned, because He, Lord Krishna, includes everyone. When the Lord is described as formless in the Vedic literatures, it is to be understood that all these forms mentioned above within the experience of universe knowledge are different exhibitions of the Lord's transcendental potencies only, and none of them factually represents the transcendental form of the Lord. But when the Lord actually descends on the earth or anywhere within the universe, the less intelligent class of men also mistake Him to be one of them, and thus they imagine the transcendence to be formless or impersonal. Factually, the Lord is not formless, nor does He belong to any of the multiforms experienced within the universal forms. One should try to know the truth about the Lord by following the instruction of Brahmaji. Second Canto, 10th chapter, 37th to 40th verse, text 37 through 40 verse is the next verse we are reading. Prajapatim manum devan, rishin pitrun gunan pritak, siddha charana gandharvan, vidyadhara suraguhyakan, kinnaradayah nagan sarpan kim purushan raran matrurakshah pisachamscha preta bhuta vinayakan kushmandonmada etalan yetudhanan grahanapi kagan drugan pashu vrikshan girin rupasharisrupan dvividaschaturvida enye jalastala nabhau kashah kushala kushala mishraha karmanam gatayastva imaha. Translation and purport by his student is A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. O King, know from me that all living entities are created by the Supreme Lord according to their past deeds. This includes Brahma and his sons like Daksha, the periodical heads like Vaivashvatamanu, the demigods like Indra, Chandra and Varuna, the great sages like Bhrugu, Vyasa and Vasishta, the inhabitants of Pitaroloka and Siddhaloka, the Caranas, Gandharvas, Vidyadharas, Asuras, Yaksas, Kinnaras and angels, the serpentines, the monkey-shaped Kimpurushas, the human beings, the inhabitants of Matriloka, the demons, Pisacas, ghosts, spirits, lunatics and evil spirits, the good and evil stars, the goblins, the animals in the forest, the birds, the household animals, the reptiles, the mountains, the moving and standing living entities, the living entities born from embryos, from eggs, from perspiration and from seeds and all others, whether they be in the water, land or sky, in happiness or in distress or in mixed happiness and distress, all of them according to their past deeds are created by the Supreme Lord. PURPORT. The varieties of living entities are mentioned in this list and with no exception from the topmost planet down to the lowest planet of the universe. All of them in different species of life are created by the Almighty Father, Vishnu. Therefore, no one is independent of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In the Bhagavad Gita 9th, 14th chapter 4th verse, the Lord therefore claims all living entities as his offspring in the following verse. Sarva yonishu kauteya murtayah sambhavantiha tasham brahma mahadyoni raham bija pradapita. The material nature is compared to the mother. Although every living being is seen to come out of the mother's body, it is still a fact that the mother is not the ultimate cause of such a birth. The father is the ultimate cause of birth. Without the father's seed, no mother can give birth to a child. Therefore, the living beings in different varieties of forms and positions within the innumerable universes are all born of the seeds of the Almighty Father, the personality of Godhead. And only to the man with the poor fund of knowledge, they appear to be born of the material nature. Being under the material energy of the Supreme Lord, all the living entities beginning from Brahma down to the insignificant ant are manifested in different bodies according to their past deeds. The material nature is one of the energies of the Lord, Bhagavad Gita 7.4. The material nature is inferior in comparison to the living entities. The superior nature and inferior nature of the Lord combine to manifest all universal affairs. Some of the living entities are relatively happy in better conditions of life, whereas others are in distressed conditions of life. But factually, none of them are actually happy in material conditional life. No one can be happy in prison life, although one may be a first-class prisoner and another a third-class prisoner. The intelligent person should not try to be promoted from third-class prison life to first-class prison life, but should try to be released from the prison altogether. One may be promoted to the first-class prisoner, but the same first-class prisoner is again degraded to a third-class prisoner the next term. One should try to be free from prison life and go back home, back to Godhead. That is the real goal for all living entities, all types of living entities. Next is the Srimad-Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 8th chapter, 25th verse. Tvam yatudhana pramata preta matra pishacha vipragraha gora drishtin darendra vitravya krishna purito bhima shvanorer radayani kampayan. O best of conscience, O Panchajanya, in the hands of the Lord, you are always filled with the breath of Lord Krishna. Therefore, you create a fearful sound vibration that causes trembling in the hearts of enemies like the Rakshasas, Pramata ghosts, Pretas, Matas, Pisachas and Brahmana ghosts with fearful eyes. Bhagavad Gita 9, chapter 25th verse, Yanti deva vrata devan pitrun yanti pitru vrataha bhutani yanti bhutejya yat madhyajinu apiman. Those who worship the demigods will take birth among the demigods. Those who worship ghosts and spirits will take birth among such beings. Those who worship ancestors go to the ancestors, and those who worship me will live with me. PURPORT. If anyone has any desire to be moon, the sun or any other planet, one can attain the desired destination by following specific Vedic principles recommended for that purpose. These are vividly described in the fruitive activities portion of the Vedas, technically known as Darsha Purnamasi, which recommends a specific worship of demigods situated on different heavenly planets. Similarly, one can attain the Pita planets by performing a specific yajna. Similarly, one can go to many ghostly planets and become a yaksha, rakshasa, raksha or pishacha. Pishacha worship is called black arts or black magic. There are many men who practice this black art and they think that it is spiritualism, but such activities are completely materialistic. Similarly, a pure devotee who worships the Supreme Personality Godhead only achieves the planets of Vaikuntha and Krishnaloka without a doubt. It is very easy to understand through this important verse that if by simply and worshipping the demigods one can achieve the heavenly planets, or by worshipping the Pita achieve the Pita planets, or by practicing the black arts achieve the ghostly planets, why can the pure devotee not achieve the planet of Krishna or Vishnu? Unfortunately, many people have no information of these sublime planets where Krishna and Vishnu live, and because they do not know of them, they fall down. Even the impersonalists fall down from the Brahma Jyoti. This Krishna consciousness movement is therefore distributing sublime information to the entire human society, to the effect that by simply chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, one can become perfect in this life and go back home, back to Godhead. Room conversation with the devotees about 12th canto Kali Yuga and conversation with guest June 15, 1974, Paris. Prabhupada. Anyway, so Vashahanna, food, Vashahanna, Vasha means residence, Vasa, Anna means food, Pana means drinking, milk or water or whatever, you require something drinking, and Shayana, sleeping or lying down on bed, Vasa, Anna, Pana, Shayana, and Vevaya, sex is also required, Vevaya, Snana. I have seen in New York, they have no place for taking bath, they have to go somewhere else, some friends come to take bath. Our students, they were coming to take bath in my room. So, snana. So, these things nil. When these things will be nil, vasha, anna, pana, sayana, vivaya, snana, bhushanahi, and dress, hina, being devoid of all these things, pishacha, shandarsha, bhavishyanti. They will be just like what is called urchins, Yogeshwara, pishachi, Prabhupada. These hippies, they are exactly like this. They have no place to sleep, nothing of the sort, and looking like big hair, pishachi, pishacha. What is the English? Nitai, ghost, Prabhupada, ghost, yes, ghost, yes, ghost like. Hinaha pishacha sandarsha bhavishyanti kalau prajaha. In the Kali Yuga, the praja, people in general, devoid of residence and proper food, then proper drinking, dressed. Resting place or sex or bathing and dress, they look like ghost then. Next is Srimad-Bhagavatam, 3rd canto, 14th verse, 14th chapter, 24th verse, 3rd canto, 14th chapter, 27th verse.